I got asked to make a quick, clean demo of the JJ's guitar pickups J90's. So that's what I'm doing. In the neck position, we've got an El Nico 2, which measures at about 7.7K. In the bridge position, we have an El Nico 4 at about 8.8K. I'm running it into one of the most neutral, clean-sounding amps that I can think of, which is the old blackface Fender Vibreverb. I'm just running an AX effects sim over here because it sounds great and neutral. And, you know, not much else. So that's the middle position, obviously. If I go to the bridge, and then the neck position. So they've kind of got that, it's almost a halfway mark between a classic old PAF, or what we imagine to be a classic old PAF, and a single coil pickup. Because they are essentially single coil pickups, right? But they've got the muscle of the humbucker with the twang of the single, which is a great thing. Also this morning I've been mucking around, sitting here trying to think of how I could possibly recreate the new Strymon Cloudburst in the Axe FX. It's their new ambient reverb pedal. Sounds pretty good too. I actually tried to buy one from the distributors, but they're all sold out, so congratulations to Strymon. But I've been mucking around, so I'll just indulge you for a moment. Hasn't quite got that string sound that the Cloudburst is exhibiting, but it's a nice wash anyway, so I call it not Cloudburst, Cloudburgzst. I wrote a couple of different scenes. one's got some formants being injected into a like a big massive plex delay. So there you go, JJ's guitar pickups, J-90's, probably the greatest P90 style pickup that I've tried ever. I replaced the old Gibbo ones in here, and the Gibbo ones are good, but these are better. These are staying in. So just to recap, we've got an El Nico 2 at 7.7K. We've got an El Nico 4 at 8.8K. See you soon. Oh, if anybody wants that preset for the XFX 3 Turbo, if you're an XFX 3 user, give me a yell and I'll put it up. Bye.